Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I wish IFFS proves to be beneficial and yield positive results. I would like to express my gratitude for SESTRIC and Turkish Participation Banking organizing this forum in this splendid city of Istanbul. Dear guests, it is clear that our Islamic banking model is far away from risks because it is based on assets. And it finances the real, actual activities rather than speculative operations. Financial leverage is also constrained with the scope and magnitude of the economic activities or productive activities. In other words, it can be easily said that the Islamic money multiplier is modest compared to the conventional money multiplier. Therefore, it is clear that the participation banking or Islamic banking can be more resilient to the crisis compared to the seen in the today's world and still continue to contribute to the development and welfare of our economies to the extent that it does not imitate or copy the financial engineering products seen in the West that created today's problems all over the world. The interest-free banking model has fair principles of loan distribution and risk sharing. Loans can be extended via financing the real needs of production or consumers. In this system, it is not possible to create and increase the debt continuously. Debt can only be created through actual purchase and sale of the services. It's not permissible to sell debt, and it is not permissible to design products based on the sale of the debt. Today, while there are $50 trillion of money in circulation globally, financially engineered products worth more than $350 trillion exist. And we see the attempts of the central banks trying to control this situation is the main issue. Unfortunately, this led us to the problem we see today. Today, this crisis seen in the USA and West Europe still causes uncertainty. Developing economies presents a relatively more resilient economic structure and performance. However, movements of portfolio money, fund movements in and out, create great impact on these countries. In a business trends of the future study by IMD professors, they conclude that the financial system is broken. Regulators want change. Businesses want new financing, new means of financing, and consumers want alternatives. The banks of the future will include state-owned banks and firms that simply don't use cash. Think bartering and community currencies. Digital wallets and mobile banking are opening the door for telecoms and software players, while trust is the entry point for retailers and crowdfunding countries. The findings of the report clearly specifies the need for Islamic banks and with their risk-mitigated model totally based on the real assets or asset-backed financing shall be the major players in the world globally, such as also in Turkey, where there is a need for core banking model based on risk and profit sharing. Dear guests, after briefly discussing the risk sharing and loan distribution, I would like to give some examples of the new product development examples of the Turkish banking, Turkish participation banking. In fact, the Sukuk side is already being mentioned from the morning till now. So I will skip this cook and I will mention the other product developed by the participation banks and which is added to the world agenda of Islamic finance. This innovative product is the gold. For years in Turkey, it has been discussed that there are more than 5,000 tons of gold kept under the pillows. New products started to be developed since 2007 to attract these savings to the banking system and to extend financing to the clients through this type of funds. And after that, the first gold saving account, gold participation account have been created. And account owners started to receive profits share in gold. And all transactions are carried with physical gold. Thus, clients with gold savings can withdraw their physical gold through Borsa Istanbul Precious Metals and Diamond Market, Istanbul Gold Exchange. As Kuwait Turk, we also started gold banking among the participation banks, and now we have around 26 tons of gold, out of 6 tons which we have generated from the directly from the customers which they kept under the piles. We hold gold collection days in the branches, and this scrap gold is converted to physical gold, gold bullions, and now it is extended to the economy as for financing. As a result, today the total gold accounts of the banking system, banking, reached to 265 tons or Turkish lira 24 billion lira, which it, as the participation banks hold 25% of this total. So there is a new product. By this way, we extended nearly 24 billion lira to the economy. And central bank, in the history of the first time of history, they started to accept gold reserves in lieu of the Turkish lira and US dollar reserves. And by this way, the central bank reserves, gold reserves, for the first time in history of the central bank, Turkish central bank, reached to 300 tons of gold. Up to now, it was 110 tons, and now central bank has more than 300 tons of gold. So by this way, the gold is designed as a financial product, and it is extended to the development of the economy. And the concluding, we believe these type of new product developments will add to the economy and will add our target to reach 10% of the market by 2023. Thank you very much.